Hello students, welcome you all to this session. So in the previous session we had started with a chapter called as control and coordination. So in this chapter we had discussed about the structure of brain, human brain. We had seen it is divided into forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Before that we had also seen the structure of nerve cell, that is neuron, how the message is transferred from one part of the body to another part of the body, and we had also seen reflex action, reflex arc with examples. Now we will continue with coordination in plants. Coordination in plants. So you know coordination, animals or human beings we have seen, there is coordination by different mechanisms like chemical responses or neurotransmitters are secreted by the nerve cells, and then the message is transferred to the brain, then only we can respond to the external stimuli or the sudden response to the changes in the environment. There is certain kind of coordination that is by nervous system. We had seen central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord, then peripheral nervous system, different parts of the brain which are responsible for performing different functions. We had seen that. Now we read about coordination in plants. Now plants don't have nervous system, right? Animals have nervous system for controlling and coordinating the bodily functions. Once again, animals have control and coordination functions, coordinating system for controlling different functions in our body. What about plants? Yes, plants also have certain coordination mechanisms. Now for take example of touch me not plant. It belongs to family Mimosa. Mimosa. Or in Hindi it is called as chui mui. We have seen this plant, right? Touch me not plant, muttidre muni anta karitare plant ge. When you touch the leaves of this plant, it suddenly droops, the leaves droops and folds up. Why does it folds or why does it do so? That is the response to the stimuli. As we take out our hand, when we touch any hot substance, we take out our hand. Or if we see a scary animal entering in the classroom or anywhere in front of us, we take out. That is our response to that external stimulation. You can see here also the leaves of touch me not plant also droop and fold up. That is the response or coordination in plants. Example is touch me not plant. Now is this growth dependent or growth independent? Now we'll come to this topic, whether it is growth dependent or growth independent. Now the leaves of this plant droop, you can see the leaves droop, right, or fold to the external stimuli, or whenever by touching the leaves it folds or the droops. Is this growth dependent or growth independent? So there are two types, growth dependent and number two is growth independent. Now one more example, if you keep the seeds, put the seeds in the soil, it germinates. After germination, the roots go below the soil and shoot develops above the ground. Is it growth dependent? Is this directional growth dependent or growth independent? Depending on that, there are two types of moments coordination in plants. One is growth dependent, other one is growth independent. So another example is germination of seeds. Germination of seeds. So when the seed germinates, the roots go below the ground and the shoot goes above the ground level. As you know, in the plant system there are two types, root system and shoot system. Root is the part below the ground or underground part of the plant, and shoot is the part which is growing above the soil, that is includes flowers, stem, branches, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. So one is growth dependent, another one is growth independent. Now this is about the coordination in plants. We are taking an example of Mimosa pudica or touch me not plant. Immediate response to stimulus. So see, this plant is immediately responding to stimulus. Immediate response to stimulus. So, you know, we are seeing examples of reflex action, reflex arc. Within a fraction of seconds, within a few minutes or seconds, you can say we take out our hand. So fast, like quickly, our coordination system is working. Our nervous system, brain, spinal cord, neurons are working in the brain. So here in plants also, there is immediate response to stimulus. In spite of that, they are not having any organs, particular organs for response to stimuli. These plants also have some chemical response which communicate. Plants also have hormones like auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins for response. Auxins, gibberellins and cytokinins. There are so many other plant hormones responsible for the immediate response to stimulus. Now, if we think about exactly which part of the plant is touched and which part of the plant is responding, that is very, very important. Now, the part of plant we are touching is the stem, for example, we are touching the stem. But where the movement is taking place, a response is showing, that is in the leaves. For example, this is the stem. And here there are the leaves. You take an example of touch me not plant, right? Mimosa pudica. Okay, now I am touching the stem. If I touch the stem, the leaves get folded or drooped. The leaves of this plant get drooped. So now here we have to think about which part of plant is being touched and from which part of plant we are getting the response. That is very important. So from here till here, from part where the part from which plant is being touched, plant is touched to the part of plant which is responding to the stimuli is very, very important. So from there also, in between, in these plants also, from the part of plant which is touched until the part of plant is responding, there is communication. This 100% is communication. Then only it is responding. The leaves are getting drooped or folded up. There is communication. But what type of communication is there? That you should know. That is very important. There are certain cells in the plant, receptors, chemical receptors, hormones, which are making them to respond to the stimuli. So there are no specialized cells as in animals, but here they have chemical substances, hormones, which are responsible for the response to stimuli. Now we'll come to movement due to growth. Movement due to growth. Here there are some examples, some mechanisms called as tropism. Movement due to growth. Now what do you mean by growth? Growth is an irreversible increase in the mass or size of an object, you can say. Now for example, some plants like pea plant, the tendrils. Pea plant tendrils, they grow on another trees like this. Tendrils, they go on increasing in the length and they go on growing on the trees by taking the support of trees. But how is the movement? It is directional. Growth is taking place. So here these plants or trees are responding with respect to growth. So growth is taking place here. So these are growth dependent, you can say. The growth of tendrils on another tree is a growth dependent factor. So in a particular direction, because this growth is directional, because it is growing in a particular direction, where the tree is in that direction, these tendrils are growing and taking the support of the tree. So this kind of growth is called directional. This we call it as directional. In particular direction, the growth is taking place. Example, tendrils of the pea plant. Now, in environmental triggers such as light, gravity, environmental triggers such as light, gravity also plays very important role here.
Now we'll take an example that how light is necessary for the growth of the plant, how it is directional. Now we see now. Now we take a potted plant. I'll tell you an experiment is given in the book. Take a potted plant and keep it on a cardboard. You take one beaker and cover that the mouth of the beaker with the mesh and keep some seeds on that mesh and keep that in a near the window from where the light is passing through that. Now after 2 to 3 days, what you will observe, there is formation of roots and shoot. Now why it is growing? Because of the light dependent. In that window the light is coming and then the shoot is growing. Now if you keep, now roots are going under the beaker but shoot is growing above the beaker. Now if you keep it in the direction where sunlight is not passing, what happens? Does the plant grow? No. So light is very essential for the growth of plant. So it is directional. If you keep in a particular direction where light is falling, then the growth takes place. Next time to gravity. See, gravity also plays a very important role. Now you are putting seeds in the soil. What happens due to gravitational force present on the earth? The plants grow. Where is the gravitational force? That is called geotropism. Tropism means in a particular direction the plant is growing. Tropism. We call it as tropism. It may be hydrotropism. Hydro means water. Hydrotropism. Geotropism, geo means earth, and chemotropism, chemotropism, chemo means the chemicals responding to. So the growth takes place in three types of directions respectively. There is a pull of growth, pull of the earth, pull of the force of the gravitation, and the plant grows. That is called geotropism. Hydrotropism means the plant is growing in water, in the direction of water, where the water is present. And chemotropism means plant is growing towards the response with the chemical reactions. It's called chemotropism. So these mechanisms are all controlled. There is also electrical chemical signals in the plants or chemical hormones you can see in the plants responsible for the growth and development of the plant. So this is all about the growth and development or the coordination in plants. So once again, what is important thing here is, as animals have hormones, animals have coordination systems, animals have response to stimuli mechanism, plants also have developed certain mechanism by which they respond to stimuli under certain conditions. How do they respond? Whether it is growth dependent or growth independent, we have seen now. Now we will go to hormones in animals. First, we'll see the meaning of hormones. Hormones are chemical messengers released by glands into the blood in trace amounts. Now, how are such chemicals or hormones transmitting the message in different animals, you can say? Now, if you see in a situation, for example, a squirrel, you have seen squirrel, how quickly it moves. If it sees any scary animal or animal be larger than that squirrel, then what does it do? There are two conditions. Either it has to fight with it or it has to escape. Now both the processes are totally different. Both require energy. They're energy requiring processes. It has to run fast. It requires energy. Or it has to fight with that animal to escape. That is also requiring energy. So both the conditions are totally different here. They are all energy dependent. Or either their body has to develop a mechanism, a kind of mechanism called as emergency conditions. We have to face certain emergency conditions. Then our body has to prepare ourselves to face those situations. How it is possible? That is possible by emergency hormones in our body. Emergency hormones released by adrenal gland in our body. Adrenal, ad means above, renal means kidney. Those glands, a pair of adrenal glands are located on the kidney, ad means above, renal means kidney. I'll show you here. So this is the kidney, then this is the adrenal gland. On each kidney there is one adrenal gland, which secretes a hormone called as adrenaline, which is responsible for the emergency situations. Emergency conditions means the brain does not think of that earlier. Suddenly those situations are coming, then only that adrenal hormone is released, like shock or surprise or can some scary situations. We think bit, we become get shocked or confused. Sometimes the hormones are released. Then here an example of squirrel is given in your book. So why this example is given? That animals moves very quickly. Suddenly it responds. Means suddenly it has to think whether I have to run away or fight with that other animal. So this kind of emergency situations come in our life also. Even we see any thief or somebody is following us or behind us, what do? We require energy. Either we have to fight that person or run away from that person, right? So we also require energy for such activities. So our body produces certain hormones which controls our body and act according to the situation. That is called adrenaline hormone or emergency hormones in our body. Then adrenaline is secreted into the blood and by which our muscles also has to respond. It is necessary for functioning of our muscles. If adrenaline hormone is secreted, then our muscles respond, then we run or fight or cope up with that situation. We either fight or run away from that situation. So muscles also play a very important role. So how this mechanism is controlled? By endocrine system in our body. Which system? Endocrine system. Endocrine means the glands. Endocrine glands are there, exocrine glands are there. They're released by the releasing hormones by particular glands. There is one gland called as pituitary gland. It is earlier it was called as master gland, but now hypothalamus is called as the master gland. Now hypothalamus is called as the master gland. Why it is called master gland? Master means what? One who controls all the functions. Master is called so because it controls and coordinates all the functions of the body. Now let us examine some examples of hormones. Now you have seen in advertisements or in newspaper, or you heard also that people will advise you to take iodized salt. You know that you have to take or consume which salt? Iodized namak anta karitare, iodized uppu anta karitare. Iodized salt means what? That salt contains iodine, an element or element only you can say, a mineral required for secretion of thyroxine hormone. Which hormone? Thyroxine hormone from thyroid gland. Now where are thyroid gland located in our body? Thyroid glands are located here, a pair of thyroid gland in the neck region, which secretes a hormone called as thyroxine. Two hormones are there actually, thyroxine and triiodothyronine. This is T4 and T3. T3, triiodothyronine, are the two hormones responsible for secretion of thyroxine hormone that is being secreted by the iodine present in a body. If we do not take iodized salt or if there is deficiency of iodine in our body, that leads to a disorder called as, or disease called as goiter. Goiter, you have heard that there is swelling in the neck region, swelling in the thyroid glands, that leads to swelling of the neck and there is pain also in the neck region. That is because of the deficiency of iodine. Deficiency of iodine leads to goiter. So we are advised to take with salt. Iodized salt is very, very essential, because if our body gets iodine, then that triggers the thyroid gland to produce thyroxine and triiodothyronine hormone in our body. That is very, very essential for the functioning of thyroid gland. Otherwise, deficiency leads to a disease called as goiter. In Kannada, galaganda roga anta karitare. Galaganda roga. Here there is swelling in the neck region. Okay. So this is one gland, a thyroid gland secretes an hormone called as thyroxine. Okay, this is one of the example. Now, sometimes we come across people who are too short or they are too tall. Right, you have seen such persons. ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದ ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಜನರು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಶಾರ್ಟ್, ತುಂಬ ಕುಳ್ಳಿಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ತುಂಬ ಉದ್ದ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ. ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ, ನಾವು ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಪರ್ಸನ್ಸ್ ಐದರ್ ಟೂ ಶಾರ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡ್ವಾರ್ಫಿಸಮ್, ಅದೇನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಡ್ವಾರ್ಫಿಸಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಲಾಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜೈಗ್ಯಾಂಟಿಸಮ್. ಜೈಗ್ಯಾಂಟಿಸಮ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್, ಅಬೌವ್ 6 feet, ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್. ಅವ್ರ ಹೈಟ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ಥರ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಅವರು. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ದ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್, ತುಂಬ ಹೈಟ್ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ತುಂಬ ಕುಳ್ಳಿಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೋ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್, ದ ನೇಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಹೆಸರಲ್ಲೇ ಇದೆ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ, ಏನು ಕಾರಣ, ಅದ್ರ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಏನು? ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹದ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ತುಂಬ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ. ಯಾವುದು? ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಎಸೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ನಾವು ಇನ್ನು ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್, ಆವಾಗ ಈ ತುಂಬ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಇದು ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಆವಾಗ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಇದು, ದಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಟ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್, ಅದು ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಶಾರ್ಟ್. ಅಥವಾ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೂಡ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಯರ್, ಹೈಪೋಸೆಕ್ರೀಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಎರಡು ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇರುತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಹೈಪೋಸೆಕ್ರೀಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಷನ್. ಹೈಪೋ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲೆಸ್, ತುಂಬ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಹೇಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೇಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ? ತುಂಬ ಕುಳ್ಳಿಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಹೈಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಷನ್, ಹೈಪರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೂಡ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಅವ್ರು ತುಂಬ ಬೆಳೀತಾನೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಡ್ವಾರ್ಫಿಸಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೈಗ್ಯಾಂಟಿಸಮ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ? ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು? ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ನೈದರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ನಾರ್ ಮೋರ್, ನೈದರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ನಾರ್ ಮೋರ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೂಡ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು, ಕಡಿಮೆನೂ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ಹುಡ್ ಡೇಸ್, ವೆನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್. ಆ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಹಿ ರಿಮೇನ್ಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ಲೈಫ್ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೈಟ್ ಡಸ್ಂಟ್ ಗ್ರೋ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ದೆನ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಜೈಗ್ಯಾಂಟಿಸಮ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೋಸ್ಟಿರೋನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ಟೆಸ್ಟೋಸ್ಟಿರೋನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೆಸ್ಟಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಓವರಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಸ್ಟಿರೋನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಟೆಸ್ಟೋಸ್ಟಿರೋನ್. ನಾವು ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ 12 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಏಜ್, ಅಟ್ ದ ಏಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೀನೇಜರ್ಸ್, ಗರ್ಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಯ್ಸ್ ನೋಟಿಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ನೋಟಿಸೇಬಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಕೆಲವು ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು, ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ, ಮಸ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಹೈ ಪಿಚ್ಡ್ ವಾಯ್ಸ್, ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ಇನ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಮೆನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಲ್ ಸೈಕಲ್. ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಇಸ್ಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇನ್ ಫೀಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟೋಸ್ಟಿರೋನ್ ಇನ್ ಮೇಲ್ಸ್. ದೇ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೇನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ? ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಪ್ಯೂಬರ್ಟಿ, ಪ್ಯೂಬರ್ಟಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಏಜ್ where a person becomes mature is called puberty. Female cell menstrual cycle and ritu chakra anta irutte. That is the female reproductive cycle in occurring in all females. That is starting because of the presence of hormone called as estrogen. Male cell testes it produces sperms responsible for secondary sexual characters in the males and females. Weirdo. Next coming to have you heard about your parents or anybody or your friends or you have heard about doctor advising a person to not to eat much sugar, right? ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. Why it is so? If a person is suffering from a disease called as diabetes. ನೀವು ಕೇಳಿರ್ಬೋದು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಯಾರಿಗಾದ್ರು ಬಂದರೆ ಚಾ ಕೇಳ್ತಿರಲ್ವಾ, ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್, ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದೆಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟೀ, ನೀವು ವಾಟ್ ಹಿಲ್ ಸೇ, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಶುಗರ್, ಅಷ್ಟು ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ವೈ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೋ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಫರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಅ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡಯಾಬಿಟೀಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ದಿ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಈಸ್? ಸಕ್ಕರೆ ಕಾಯಿಲೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತಾರೆ ಶುಗರ್. ಡಯಾಬಿಟೀಸ್, ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿಲಿ ಒಂದು ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ pancreas. You have seen digestive system, right? I just draw here. Draw it a bit straight. Okay, this is mouth, esophagus, stomach barateli. Intestines. Here comes the pancreas. Here comes the liver. So this gland is called pancreas. Pancreas is a dual gland. Children, one thing ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು, ಇದು ಡುವೆಲ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಡುವೆಲ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಎಕ್ಸೋಕ್ರೈನ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಂಡೋಕ್ರೈನ್. ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೀಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್. ಈ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನನ್ನು ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್. ಈಗ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಏನು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್? ಇಟ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ನ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ವಿಚ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್? ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್. ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾವುದು? ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಸ್, ಆರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಥರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್, ಬೀಟಾ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಐಲೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟ್ ಅ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್, ವಿಚ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. Now, if this insulin is not secreted in adequate amount, then what happens? Then the blood sugar level is not regulated and the person suffers from a disease called as diabetes. That's why these people who are suffering from diabetes, they take insulin injections. Our body alli pancreas in madutte ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟೆಡ್, ಹೌ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್? ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಟು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ದೆನ್ ದೆ ಟೇಕ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲಿ ದೋಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಟು ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ಸೊ ನಾ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ನಾವ್? ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ನೈದರ್ ಮೋರ್ ನಾರ್ ಲೆಸ್. ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೂಡ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು, ಕಡಿಮೆ ಕೂಡ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಹೈಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಪೋ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೈಪರ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್. ಹೈಪರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸೀನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ದೆನ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೂ ಟಾಲ್. ಹೈಪೋ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ದೆನ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಶಾರ್ಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಬೈ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಷನ್, ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಮ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಅದರ್ ಮೋರ್ ನಾರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಿಂಗ್. ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ರೈಸ್, ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಆ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ? ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್. ಎಸ್, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ವೆನ್ ಆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ರೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ದ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಲೆವೆಲ್. ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ being reduced, automatically the secretion of insulin also is reduced. So there is communication here. So what is there is coordination, control and coordination. Hege blood sugar level rise agutte, pancreatic cells ge message hogutte enanta insulin secret aagbeku. ಯಾವಾಗಿದು ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಷನ್ ಬೈ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಷನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನ್ಯೂರೋ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಪ್ಯಾಂಕ್ರಿಯಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ರೈಸಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್. ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. So this is all about the endocrine glands, hormones in animals. So here completes your chapter called as control and coordination. So what all you have studied in this chapter? So in this chapter, you have studied about the reflex action, reflex arc, response to stimuli, structure of brain. Most important, you practice the diagram of human brain, forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain with functions. And the controlling centers. Then coming to coordination plants. An example, taking an example of plant, touch me not plant or chewy mui plant. An example is given. Then coming to response to water, earth and light. How the plants are growing, whether growth dependent or growth independent. Then coming to last one, hormones in animals. We have seen growth hormone, thyroxine. Thyroid gland and an example of pancreas, that is the hormone called as insulin. So here completes the chapter. So read the notes, notes will be given to you.